to find a way to hit the player away from the puck. It has as much speed as possible.
The Wings won the first two games of the series at the Joe Louis Arena by scores of 4-1 and 4-0. The Jets got back in the series last Sunday with an impressive 4-1 win. It looked as though it was all over when the Wings won game four by a score of 6-1. But with Nikolai Havivil outstanding in goal in game five with 51 saves, the Jets forced their sixth game here at the Winnipeg Arena. But unless Winnipeg can mount some offense in this third period with 13:34 remaining, there will not be a seventh game Tuesday night at the Joe Louis Arena.
You know, Don, the Jets have been attacking pretty much from the beginning of the second period on, so that's a full 27 minutes of attacking, but they haven't been able to get any shots against Detroit. And you just have to really marvel at how disciplined the Red Wings are.
Oh, Chad Kilger just missed with a quick release as he was able to steal the puck. He scored the game-winning goal a week ago Sunday. A week ago today, actually, here at the arena last Sunday in the Jets 4-1 win. Konstantinov now, under pressure, will fire at the length of the ice. Abby Bullen is forced to make the save, so there is no icing. Now it's Severdovsky, wheeling away from Malte. He moves it ahead to Stapleton. Stapleton whips it in high on the glass. Taylor taking it hard against the board. Stapleton has, he can't free himself from Johnson, and now Malte will clear. And again, Brian, your point. The moment the Red Wings realize they're in trouble, they dump it out.
And they make, for the most part, pretty darn good dumps, too. They don't take a lot of icing calls. They keep those seconds, precious seconds for the Winnipeg Jets, ticking away.
15,567 have been roaring their approval for the play of the Winnipeg Jets this afternoon, but they've been disappointed by the lack of goal scoring and the fact that the inability to beat Mike Bergevin could end the hockey season and the franchise life of the Jets. The Tuck will try and get something going, but his backhand pass intended for Zhamnov was blocked. Larionov turns it the other way. He had problems controlling against Numinen. Now Kozlov looking for the hat trick up high on Havivolin. Zhamnov circles in his own zone, and very quickly the Red Wings move back to try and defend. Zhamnov moves it across to Numinen. He'll drive it in. Korolev goes after it, but he's beaten to the puck by Kozlov. Now Manson pinches in from the point. The puck is fed out to MacIver. He shoots, scores!
Aggressively gone out and really tried to generate some offense. Detroit, for the most part, has been able to shut them down. Look at MacIver. Knows exactly where he wants to go with that puck. Takes a little peek before he releases the shot. And so important, the work of Keith Tkachuk in front of Mike Vernon. He pays the price. That's what buys MacIver the time.
A 3-1 hockey game, and the assists go to Korolev and Manson on Norm MacIver's goal. The first point of the postseason for Norm MacIver. more aggressive, and it was Dave Manson pinching in from the point that forced that turnover.
And as he's done all series, Terry Simpson follows up a goal.